that socializing side of things can lead you down the dark path.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm lucky I steered clear of all of that. I've never been someone into drugs and stuff like that, but I've been around a lot of it.
Mm-hmm.
And I do feel that that's something you have to also pay attention to.
Yeah.
If you really love music and you really want to do what you do that for a career, stay focused about why you're there. It's not for partying 24/7.
No.
It's for, you know, loving what you do and doing a good job, really.
Yeah,
you know?
I mean, the high should be on stage, not after it. You know?
Yeah.
Or, you know, or that moment in the studio where that's just been put down and you listen back to it and you go, yeah. But of course, then a lot of people then take that excitement and put it in a line on the table or in a bottle, and you know,
and then
before you know it, that can take over the care and integrity for the music in the first place, which is what got you there to experience that high, to then want to replicate it. So
it's not going to be the same sort of high as the joy of connecting with musicians and connecting with the music. I mean, that buzz is replicable, but buzzes from alcohol are subject to all sorts of things, and they don't tend to be a true feeling.
Yeah.
But the feeling, that emotion, you felt that. You've been moved to tears.
Oh, absolutely.
When you've been on stage, like through just sheer joy and just like everything, oh my God.
Oh, yeah. I know.